Hi everybody, my name's Mark Thurston and I'm the Chief Executive of HS2. It's January, it's 2023, a new year, and here I am at our Curzon Street site in Birmingham, bringing you our latest update video on the progress we're making on the HS2 programme. 2022 was a huge momentous year for the project. We made progress on multiple fronts, permanent structures being installed right along the route, and what you're going to hear about today is the progress we've made since the last video and what's in front of us in 2023. We start 2023 with a fantastic celebration for us. We've now had 1,000 apprenticeship starts here on the programme, part of our target to have 2,000, so we're halfway through, and for someone who started their career as an apprentice, this is a really pleasing moment for me. And as this project moves further north from here, Birmingham, ultimately all the way through Crewe and into Manchester, will create even more opportunities for people right across the country to join the HS2 programme. In our last update in October, I was in northwest London at our West Ryslip compound, where we were launching our fourth and fifth tunnelling machines, Sushila and Caroline. Since that video, I've been on site at Long Itchington with our new Secretary of State, Mark Harper, where we were able to see the first of the two tunnels along Itchington, which is now complete. And that machine, Dorothy, is now being used for the second drive, and she's well on her way to completing the second tunnel later this year. Behind me here on the site at Curzon Street, the teams are finalising the first V-shaped pier. These piers, 30 of which will support the 300 metre long viaduct that will bring trains from the southeast of Birmingham almost parallel to the existing railway and into our new station at Curzon Street just over my left shoulder. These viaducts, along with those of the 150 metre section just to the south of here, will transform the city skyline and create opportunities for new public spaces to add to the life of the city. In total, we'll be building more than 500 bridging structures, including over 50 major viaducts, which will stretch right across the valleys, rivers and roads and floodplains of which this railway needs to travel. A really positive end to 2022 was that 10 HS2 sites are now diesel free. Throughout this year, we look forward to continuing to facilitate green innovation trials and working with the industry to pioneer cleaner and greener ways of working, supporting our journey towards fully diesel free construction by 2029. We've recently celebrated our first 5 years of habitat creation and tree planting along the route, effectively creating our green corridor. We've planted some 845,000 trees and bushes, and we've created 119 new wildlife sites. And our environmental team's already now thinking about and working towards their sixth planting season here in 2023. So three things to finish. Firstly, we'll continue to create opportunities and careers for people who want to join our industry, join HS2, and effectively become the next generation of workers for the construction and engineering sector. Secondly, you can see we've got great momentum on HS2, more sites opening up. Our workforce will grow from some 30,000 to 34,000 people right across the country, and we're well on our way to building what will become the world's most sustainable high-speed rail network. And lastly, with many milestones in front of us this year, we look forward to bringing you our next update in the spring of 2023. Thanks very much.